The level 180 target was doing way too much damage at the start of the pillage, but it is a lot easier now. Hey everyone, Derpy here, welcome back to another Battle Pirates video. I was taking about 2 hours, 2.5 hours damage in this target, and now it is significantly lower. Let's go ahead and run through this, and at the same time I'll give you a few driving tips as I do show this so you can help reduce your damage too. Regardless if you have 4 ships fully armored or 3 ships just partly built, some of these tips should be applicable. The overall plan for engaging the target is to go towards the bottom here, start over this area, rotate off to the right, loop around the entire target, and then come through the left side here, which I'll explain why a little bit closer to that. Now the first thing you have to realize is that this ship only fires when it's stopped or above water, which is pretty much the same thing unless you drive it a little bit weird. So I stopped right by the Saturn here to do some damage to it, and I was also getting hit by a few things. The next thing you should realize is you can outrange a few turrets, especially the Sentinel ones. It's not quite every pixel, but it is pretty close, so you do need to use that down arrow key to stop all your ships. The next thing you should try doing is stay moving when you are near the Mongoose turrets. This means you will take less damage from them because you'll be moving, their splash damage, they're going to miss you a little bit. Also, my ship is playing a little bit of ice hockey here, so things might actually be dead when they're not. There we go. You can pretty much ignore the bombard turrets, they really don't do anything except if you're using an Everest fleet. Let's take another look at the Mongoose turret right here. It's firing at me, I stay moving, hopefully I reduce some of that damage. I stop right here and shoot this guy down. I did go in range of that long range halo missile turret in the middle of the target, which is why you saw a few things coming at me from that direction. The hitboxes are always just a little bit bigger than you think. I'm going to stay moving here until I'm in range of both things here, so I just have to stop one time, scoot a little bit closer, and you can see I hit that guy even though I definitely was not in range yet, even though it sort of said I was. There we go again, triggering the halo missile. That's not ideal, I'm taking some damage from that, but not a ton, it's not too bad. These sentinels seem to be where the majority of the damage comes from. Again, stay moving against these monkeys, and then when you are close enough that you can kill them and they've stopped shooting, then you can stop. Try and stay away from these UAV guys if at all possible. They are a little bit rude and are not very helpful. Oh, by the way, I am running 4 ships, no armor whatsoever, old armor, new armor, there's none of those on here, and I will show you the build at the very end of the video, so stay around for that if you are interested in. Against the Sentinel turret right here, you might take some more damage from this halo missile when you're killing this guy, but I think it is worth it just to try and do it quickly and stay out of range if possible. But if you do get in range, no worries, you're rimming the target and making it easier for yourself. Now yes, it has been 2 minutes and I haven't actually gone inside yet, but we're almost quite there, and notice I did not run through the right entrance. I'm staying off to the left here against a few different things, even though I am getting hit by some stuff, really doesn't matter. If I am in range of this guy, we might as well make the most of it and grab the ship here. I actually forget what those things were called, Avenger, something like that. Now, you'll notice I'm not running in through the top over through this open area because there's a lot more turrets around there, which is something that Pegleg pointed out to me. Instead, I'm going to go through the bottom here where I only have to get through one gate, which should actually be fine because these gates do it like dying like 2 volleys, same as the turrets, 2 or 3 volleys, which is fantastic. So a few shots off at this guy, a few shots off at the gate, stay moving a little bit, and we are pretty much in. Take down the halo missile, 3 shots at that guy, 3 shots at the bottom mongoose, 3 shots at the Avenger ship right here, and that is everything shooting at me in this immediate area down. Where if I enter from the top, there's like 2 ships, 2 different turrets I have to go towards, so I'll try and avoid that if possible. Again, against these mongoose turrets, try and stay moving. You'll notice I don't really care about getting too close to them because all these different sentinel turrets are dead, so I don't have to worry about outranging anything here at all. One thing that you might want to try as well is a rocket if it does work. As far as crews, I would say steelheads is one that always works fairly well, regardless of what the target is, because it reduces damage taken by 15% from everything, period, in PvE. Alright, just zooming out here, there are a few other things to go towards. Should just be bombard turrets so we can split our ships up a little bit, and that should be fine. One tip I have for you is if you want to drive your ships and shoot at the same time, you can do that by driving a little bit, stopping, forward, stop, forward, stop, forward, stop, forward, stop, just like that, so you can actually stay shooting at something while you're moving, if that is something you are interested in. You do take half the damage if you are underwater, so you do want to keep that in mind as you're going through this target. Well, let's go ahead and check the build, the battle report, and the damage, and see just how bad it is. I did mention at the start I was taking about, say, 2 hours damage. It should be significantly less. Damage taking is a little bit more penetrative. Not really sure why, to be honest. I think it's closer to even for a lot of people. They're actually mentioning it's way more penetrative taken. What I can show you is I'm getting about 50% of each one. And I'm shooting down just a tiny bit of explosive and evading some penetrative in general. 48 minutes of repair time, which is pretty good compared to 2 hours 15 minutes at the start. So try and use a few of these driving tips I've showed you, as well as the just damage being reduced in general. Kixeye reduced it from the start of the event. Here's the build I'm using. It is 4 ships exactly like this one, all unarmored. Just these 6 specials, and all weapons are the regular unlimited blueprint. It's the only one we have right now. With that, I'm going to go ahead and say thank you everyone for watching. Thank you to everyone whose name appears on screen now. And as always, this is Derpy signing out, helping you be a better pirate.